I'm having a bad, bad day. It's about time that I get my way. Steamrolling whatever I see. Huh, despicable me. I'm having a bad, bad day. If you take it personal, that's okay. Watch, this is so fun to see. Despicable me. Why ask why, better yet, why not? Why are you marking X on that spot? Why use a blowtorch, isn't that hot? Why use a chainsaw, is that all you got? Why do you like seeing people in shock? But my question to you is why not? Why go to the bank and stand in line? Just use a freeze gun, it saves me time. I'm having a bad, bad day. It's about time that I get my way. Steamrolling whatever I see. Oh, despicable me. I'm having a bad, bad day. If you take it personal, that's okay. Watch, this is so fun to see. Oh, despicable me.
Okay, we are starting.
Oh wait, well, we're starting now. Okay.
Oh, wait a second.
I'm not ready.
Wait, do we have everybody?
No,
he has to record all this first. Yeah.
Groom walks to the bar and sees a child. The child sad about the drop ice cream cone. He stops and makes the child a balloon animal. He gives the child a balloon animal. And then promptly fucking murders it. Gru moves the child's
side. Okay. This is, I'm Gru, so I have to pop the balloon. Okay, there. Pop the balloon. All right.
Gru walks down the street to his favorite coffee shop, Starbucks. God, he's so white. Gru enters. The line is a mile long. Jesus Christ, this is one fucking long-ass Starbucks. With a groan. Pulls out his fucking
sweater. Right, that's my gun! Come again!
He aims and... snap!
Please leave!
Once Gru is done committing several felonies, he walks to the head of the line, past the frozen customers. He approaches the terrified barista before daintily taking a cup of coffee from her and plopping a coin into the tip jar. Exit city street. Cars drive down a busy city street. First a sub-combat car, then an SUV, then an enormous metallic beast of a car that Gru at the wheel. He sips his coffee. And then there's some scene of him of his mom calling, but we don't need that. Exterior Gru's house, morning. In the middle of a typical suburban street sits a black, creepy looking house. Gru pulls his car into the driveway. Gru walks down from his car towards the fence.
Morning, Gru! How are you doing?
Hello, Fred. FYI. Your dog has been leaving little bombs all over my yard and I don't appreciate it.
Sorry, you know dogs. They go wherever. They want. You know.
Unless they're dead. I was just joking. Of course, although it is true. Anyway, have a good one.
Ah, okay. Yes.
Gru washed into the living room carrying his Starbucks and a muffin. Just sat on the couch, he sees his dog tail across between a piranha and pitbull, snoring loud sound, lying in the bed. Gru uses his foot to roll Kyle over. Gru sits down to enjoy his coffee and muffin. He just turns on the TV when dang dong! Gru grimaces and gets up from the table. He's not on a table, he's on a couch!
Oh, you've got to be pulling on my leg.
Gru arrives at the door, holding a club in his free hand. How fucking strong is this guy, Jesus? He hears a little girl's voice on the other side. Hello? Cookies for sale? Gru stops looking through the front door, revealing Margo, Edith, and Agnes. Three little
girls. Anus.
Zaddy's cookies. Agnes holds a ragged stuffed unicorn. She's never without it.
Go away, I'm not home.
You're not, Mark, with Margo and the other girls on the doorstep. Yes, you are. I heard you.
No, you didn't. This is a recording.
No, it isn't.
Yes, it is. Watch this. Leave me a message. Beep.
Edith kicks at the door. There's a muffle. There's a muffled.
Ooh.
From the other side of the door. The girl walks up. The girls walk off. Agnes waves. Goodbye, recorded message. Come on. And then the girls leave, I guess. Interior Gruslayer. Girl walks back into the living room. Kyle is nowhere to be found. He looks around and suddenly... Talk! Kyle has devoured half of Gru's arm.
Kyle, bad dog. No. See it. No, my muffin.
He tries to shake the dog, and suddenly the TV flashes.
We don't need to narrate everything. Adam could just pitch in whatever he wants.
Okay. Incoming call!
Gru.
Dr. Nefario.
I know what you must be feeling. I too have experienced great disappointment. But in my eyes, you will always be one of the greats.
What? What happened?
It's all over the news. Some fella just stole a pyramid. They're saying he makes all other villains look lame.
Assemble the minions. Minions assemble. Somebody has to be a minion.
hang on, I got this.
Banana.
Aha, looking good. All right. How's the family? Good. All right. That's my Billy boy. What up, Larry? Hello, everybody. All right. Settle down. Thank you. Okay. Now I realize that you guys have probably heard that this other villain who stole the pyramid apparently is a big deal. People have been calling it the crime of the century and stuff like that. But am I upset? No, I am not. A little, but we have had a pretty good year ourselves. And you guys are already in my book. No raises. You're not going to get any raises. What did we do? Well, we stole the Times Square Jumbotron. Well, that's not all. We have stolen the Statue of Liberty. The small one from Las Vegas. And I won't even mention the Eiffel Tower. Also Vegas. Okay, I wasn't going to tell you about this yet, but I have been working on something very big. Something that will blow this pyramid thing out of the water. And now, thanks to the efforts of my good friend, Dr. Nefario. Dr. Nefario.
Thank you.
Oh, there he is. He's smiling. Beep. We have located a shrink ray in the secret lab. And once we take the shrink ray, we will have the capability to pull off the true crime of the century. We are going to steal. Wait, I haven't told you what it is yet. Hey, Dave, listen up, please. Next, we are going to steal, pause for effect, the moon. At once, the moon is mine. The world will give me whatever I want to get it back. And I will be the greatest villain of all time. That's what I'm talking about. I do the phone ring. Yes.
Hello, group. I've been crunching some numbers and I really don't see how we can afford this. It can't be done. I'm not a miracle worker.
Hey, chillax. I'll just get another loan from the bank. They love me. Bow, 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 bow. Okay. Wait, what's going on right now?
What is going on?
Sorry, I'm running a game in the background.
Who the hell put banana on the
The moon shines brightly in the sky. Margot, Edith, and Agnes walk down the sidewalk. Edith leaping from puddle to puddle. Splash! Edith gets water all over Margot. Edith, stop it!
What? I'm just walking.
The three girls then enter the orphanage! Interior, Miss Hattie's home for girls. The reception area features a pink flowery wallpaper and pink furniture and perfectly stacked plates and boxes of Miss Hattie's cookies. Setting up the reception desk is Miss Hattie! Ding! The girls enter the room and line up behind the yellow line before they call out to Miss Hattie. Hi, Miss Hattie. We're back. Hello, girl. Anybody come to adopt us while we were out? Let me think. No. Yeah. Edith happily places a ball of wine on Miss Hattie's desk. Miss Hattie stares, losing it. Edith, did you put on my desk?
A mud pie.
Miss Hattie looks at you right in the eyes. You're never going to get adopted, Edith. You know that, don't you?
Yeah, I know.
So, how did it go, girls? Did we meet our quotas? Sorta. We used 42 mini mints, 30 chocolate sterling, and 18 coconuts. It's sad he stares at the heck of the girls. It's still using enough to reflect me.
We need more
rules. Okay, well.
So Jesse's gonna be the box
kid. Look in my face. Do you still think it's a great sale day? I think we can do a little better than that, don't you? Yeah. You wouldn't want to spend the beginning of my shame. No, Miss Daddy. Okay, good. Off you go. Go bring something to mine. The girls pass by a cardboard box labeled Box of Shame through the small hole. But on one side, two frames, a small child can be made out. Hi, Penny. Hi, guys. Interior, Groove's car. Groove drives his enormous car down the street. His phone rings. Oh, here's the phone scene.
Wait, who's Marlena Groove? Who's Groove's mom?
Oh, I'm going to get no underwear.
Hello, Mom. Sorry I meant to call, but...
I just wanted to congratulate you on stealing the pyramid. That was you, wasn't it? Or was it a villain who actually successful?
You have to crack yourself up.
Oh!
Just wait, so you know, Mom, I'm about to do something very big, very important. When you hear about it, you're going to be very proud.
Oh, good luck with that. Okay, I'm out of here.
Groove pulls up in front of a van. There is a small space in between two cars. Except, and Groove forgot how to parallel park and
yeah,
just...
Okay, let's just sum this all up because I've noticed how much there's actually to narrate.
Yeah, there's a lot of narrate.
And Groove... But then Groove walks into the bathroom to take a piss, but oh no, he gets his eye scanned. The door opens to reveal the Bank of Evil. He heads it to the receptionist. Stuff.
Groove to see Mr. Perkins.
Yes, please have a seat.
Groove takes a seat.
Oh shit.
Then,
oh, this is the child. It occurs.
Hold on, I got the voice for this.
It's one small step for man, one giant leap for mankind.
Mom, someday I'm going to go to the moon.
I am afraid you're too late, son. NASA isn't sending the monkeys to moon anymore.
Adam,
what?
Adam, look what's ahead. All right, hey, Jesse.
Narration. Come on.
Yeah, have a little bit of a narration. Come up to Vector. Okay. You gotta have a little bit of an introduction.
Goop was having the plan, revealing and sitting across from him in a black velvet chair is a nerdy villain in a costume with glasses, a prominent nose, left shoulder, and a pot belly. His name is Vector, and he is cocked way beyond any realistic assessment of his prowess.
Hey, I'm applying for a new villain. Got the name of Vector. It's a mathematical term. A quantity represented by an arrow with both direction and magnitude. Vector, that's me, because I'm committing crime with both direction and magnitude. Oh, yeah. Check out my new weapon, Piranha Gun. Oh, yes. Fires live piranhas. Ever seen one before? No, you haven't. I invented it. You want a demonstration?
You make Vector seem like he wears camouflage everywhere he goes.
Ah, shoot. So difficult sometimes to get the piranha back inside my...
Mr. Grill, Mr. Perkins, will you now?
Who sits across from Mr. Perkins, the bank's unforgetting loan manager, a monster of a man with devil horn hair, who is surrounded by charts and models showing how he is going to steal the moon.
So, all I need is money from the bank to build a rocket, and then the moon is ours.
Wow. Well, very nice presentation. I'd like to see this shrink ray.
Absolutely, will do. Soon as I have it.
You don't have it, and yet you have the audacity to ask the bank for money.
Apparently.
Do you have any idea of the capital that this bank has invested in you, Gru? With far too few of your plans... with far too few of your sinister plots actually turning a profit. How can I put it? Let's say this apple is you. If we don't start getting our money back... Get the picture? Look, Guru, the point is, there are a lot of new villains out there, younger than you, hungrier than you, younger than you. Like that young fellow out there named Vector. He just stole the pyramid.
Boom. I've got it. So, as far as getting money for the rocket...
Get the shrink ray, then we'll talk.
A beaten down Gru leaves Mr. Perkins' office. He walks past Vector, who is trying to stick the piranha back in his gun. Looks around, casually pulls out the freeze ray gun, and freezes his head. Vector moves his eyes to look at Gru before his body hits the floor. The piranha jumps out in the air, and on top of the now defenseless Vector, he gives out a scream as he is bitten.
Ah!
A satellite of a large landmass on a flashing red square shrinks down over a river running through the landscape. Zoom in to an overview of a massive industrial complex located on the island. Gru's ship speeds through the sky.
Holy shit, there's a lot of narrating.
Gru sits at the controls. A couple of minions are with him. A worker a bunch of workers test the shrink ray. They figure out it worked. Gear's plane flies toward the lab. Shrink ray works. It's good. Gru's massive aircraft hovers above the research facility with the claws, arm feeding from the belly of the ship. A minion riding the claw plucks the shrink ray from its sand. The minion carefully tries to ascend through the freshly cut hole. And then finally breaks it. The minion rides the arm up to Gru's plane. The plane takes off into the sky. Gru sits at the controls, a couple of minions are with him.
We got it.
Shrink Ray is then cut out of the ship and is away.
Oh, no. Hey.
A larger ship hovering above. It's Vector, the wannabe villain from the bank. He looks down at Gru and yells to him.
You.
Ha! Now maybe you'll think twice before you freeze someone's head. So long, Gru.
Have you watched Despicable Me?
I have.
Quick, we can't let them get away.
Adam.
Yeah. Up ahead. Fire! Fire now!
You missed me.
Ah, come to Papa.
Take that. How adorable.
Got you in our sights like taking candy from a what?
Vector is on top of the ship.
Hey, Gru, take this for size.
Oh, that's weird. What's going on? Claustrophobic. Oh, no. No. Too small. This is too small for me. Ah, I hate that guy.
And the ship's like...
There are three beds in a tiny room. The three girls near the rest sitting there. And please watch over us, and bless them, we'll have a good night's sleep.
And bless that while we're sleeping, no bugs will crawl into our ears and lay eggs in our brains.
Great. Thanks for that.
See, I wanted him to be Edith.
And please bless that someone will adopt us soon. The mommy and daddy will be nice. And have a pet unicorn. Amen.
The girls climb into their beds. Margot turns out the light. Agnes begins singing first. Exterior, Vector's Fortress! Vector's Fortress is a massive marble building with a huge V on the front. If that wasn't fucking obvious... Vector's Fortress. Gru, in a Rastafarian disguise, walks an artificial dog down the street. A security camera notices Gru, but he pins his back to the wall, which somehow the camera can't fucking see him anymore. A shark and a school of fish in Vector's lair swim under the floor of the house. Vector lounges on his couch playing his epic Nintendo Wii.
Okay, where are we?
Page 23. Activates a puppy periscope. It is burnt to a crisp with a laser. Then a montage begins.
Yeah, this is just a narration montage.
A mechanical washing glove punches him in the face. through 4 volts into the wall, and bam, mechanical box blows repeatedly in the nuts. No goals for him. Uses a jetpack to fly over a wall. A giant catapult flings him off the roof. Bazooka at the front gate. The gate fucking kills him.
Oh, yeah.
The Vector rubs the keyboard on his fucking ass.
Oh, no, we know where we're at.
Finally, 1 million other weapons transform from the roof. Then Bruce sees the girls approaching Vector's front gate. He laughs bitterly as security cameras are activated and the girls ring Vector's buzzer. Gru chuckles.
Oh, good luck, little girl.
Gru watches them with binoculars. Miss Hattie's delicious orphan cookies. The guns emerge from Vector's dome, aimed at the front door.
Whoa, cool.
Hi. We're orphans from Miss Hattie's Home for Girls.
I don't care. Beat it.
Oh, come on. We're selling cookies, so, you know, we can have a better future.
Oh, wait. Do you have coconutties?
Yeah.
The door then. The guns retract as well, allowing the girls to enter. Gru has a fucking PTSD flashback of the girls carrying out the shrink ray. Back to reality. Gru's eyes light up.
Light bulb. Dr. Navario.
Huh?
I'm gonna need a dozen of tiny remote control robots that look like cookies.
What?
Cookie robots.
Who is this?
Cookie. Oh, forget it.
The group laughs with newfound hope. A bunch of time later, Miss Hattie sits at her desk across from someone. She's checking on her computer screen. Gru sits across from her in an all-white dentist outfit.
Well, it appears you've cleaned out background check. Dr. Gru.
Miss Hattie types a few strokes.
Oh, and I see you know this. Personal achievements. Thank you for that. I love reading.
I'm reading the computer, then types random information into it.
I see you have been given a medal of honor and a knife with you. You have your own cooking show. I can hold your breath for 30 seconds. Is that that impressive?
The minions then begin fighting over who to type.
What?
It's well now.
Here's the dealio. Things have been lonely since my wife, Debbie, passed on. It's like my heart is a tooth, and it's got a cavity.
As well, it could be filled with children.
I'm sorry. You're a beautiful woman. Do you speak Spanish?
Well, look like I speak Spanish.
You have a face como un burro.
Oh, thank you.
Anyway, can we proceed with this adoption? So excited.
Edith and Agnes to come to the lobby. Close on. Screaming mouths of Edith and Agnes. And the girls burst into their tiny room screaming. They furiously put things into their suitcases. Marco removes a poster from the ballerina. Edith packs her stick collection. I bet it's beautiful.
I bet the daddy's eyes sparkle.
I bet their house is made of gummy bears.
Oh,
be nice.
anus.
Aw, a caterpillar never turned into a butterfly.
That's a Cheeto.
Oh, I knew that.
Groot and Asadi then middle of the conversation.
Oh, yeah. Debbie was a really lucky woman.
Who's Debbie?
He's not. Oh, hi, girls. Girls, I want you. Mr. Green, he's going to adopt you. And he's a dentist. Oh, hi, I'm Margo. This is Edith. That's Agnes. I got your leg! I got your leg!
Hey, that's enough, little girl. Let go of my leg. Come on, you can do it. Just release the grip. Wow. How do you remove them? Is there a command to some non-stick spray crowbar? Okay, girls, let's go.
Edgar's car pulls away from the orphanage.
Hmm.
Sounds like a little kid's balloon to pop. He cries like a fucking loser. Edgar flips on turbo, rockets down the street. He then jettisons off the cliff. Dies.
Pretty impressive. What are you looking at? Booyah. You got shrunk, tiny mouthwash. Psh, take that. You done been shrunk. Yellow. Oh, I got the shit gray, all right. No, I'm not playing with it. Groot, don't make me laugh, no. P.S. He's not going to get in the moon, and P.P.S. by the time I'm done with him, he's going to be begging for mercy for his husband. Okay, bye. Aw, look at you, a little bitty toilet for a little tiny bitty. Aw, curse you, tiny toilet.
Green, the girls get out of the car and walk to his front door.
Okay, here we are. Home sweet home.
So is this, like, your house? Wait a second. You're the guy who pretended he was a recorded message.
No, that was Dave.
What did you say about me?
No, that's Fred.
This is ridiculous.
Girls look around, taking in the very scary-looking interior.
I'm
not
holding your hand.
All right, now 33.
No.
When we got adopted by a bald guy, I thought this would be more like Annie.
Who's Annie?
I saw Kylo around the corner. His eyes lighting up as he sees the girls. He licks his chops and fucking upcharges their asses like a police on a coke job.
No, hey, Kyle, these are not treats, these are our guests. Girls, this is Kyle, my dog.
Ooh, fucking doggy!
Kyle,
aww.
What kind of dog is that?
He's, Serbian.
I don't. It's an appropriate place for little kids because it's not.
No, no. Stay away from there. It's fragile. Oh. Well, I suppose the plan will work with you.
Hey, it's dark in here. It poked a hole in my it poked a hole in my juice box.
As you can see, I have interrupted the narrator and everything a child might need. Now I've got. Hey!
Somebody broke that.
Okay. Clearly, we need to set some rules. Rule number one: you will not touch anything.
What about the floor?
Yes, you may touch the floor.
What about the air?
Yes, you may touch the air.
What about this?
Ah! Where did you get that?
Found it.
Okay, room number two. You will not bother me while I'm working. Rule number three. You will not cry, or whine, or laugh, or giggle, or sneeze, or burp, or fart. So no annoying sounds, all right?
This cat has annoying. Bury the lies deep within.
Very. I will see you in 6 hours.
Okay. Don't worry. Everything's going to be fine. We're going to be really happy here. Right, Agnes? Agnes? Hmm?
Question. What are these?
A dozen boogie robots. Boogie! Look at this. What? Watch me.
Cookie robots. I said cookie robots, not boogie robots. Why are you so old?
Okay, I'm on it.
Agnes.
Kyle then tries to sneak up on Agnes, but Agnes hits the fucking evil layer button. Which.
Agnes is the Theodore of them.
Elevator to Gru's evil lair then opens up. What is that?
Whoa, Edith. That's cool. Come on.
I think he's a dentist.
We've been working on this for a while. It's an anti-gravity serum.
Beat a ball!
I meant to close that. He'll be alright, I'm sure.
Do the effects wear off?
So far, no. No, they don't. And here, of course, is the new weapon you ordered.
No, I said dart gun. I said, okay.
Oh, yes. Because I was wondering what circumstances we would use this. But anyway, what I really wanted to show you is this.
Agnes.
Now those are cookie robots lying. And then eggs come in.
Well, now I'm not going to say it because you told us.
Okay, fine.
Now those are cookie robots.
La, 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 I love unicorns. I love unicorns.
What are you doing here? I told you to stay in the kitchen.
We got bored. What is this place?
Can I drink this? Do you want to explode? Gru.
Get back in the kitchen.
Will you play with us?
No.
Why?
Because I am busy.
Doing what?
Okay, you got me. The dentist thing is more of a hobby. In real life, I am a spy. And it is top secret, and you may not tell anybody, because if you do...
What does this do?
The unicorn has now been disintegrated.
Whoops.
Unicorn! Hey. You have to fix it!
Fix it? Look, it has been disintegrated. By definition, it cannot be fixed. That's freaking me out. What is she doing?
You gotta hold her head until she gets a new one.
It's just a toy. Now stop it.
Mm-hmm.
Okay, okay, I'll fix it. Team Mark, Phil. This is very important. You have to get a little girl a new unicorn toy.
A boy.
Hey, 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 boy, go and hurry.
What are those?
They are my cousins. Jerry Stewart. Watch them and keep them away from me, please.
Got some minion scenes.
Oh, no. No.
The minions walk into the store. They do some shit. One of them inflates like a balloon with shaken soda. And then, then one of them starts doing fucking karaoke.
Hey, now, it's Harmony now. Oh, hey, good morning. Do soon. Hey, I can be the
Later in that evening, Gru's entire interior of his house has been toilet paper.
Oh god.
Gru comes in and Edith blames the minions.
It was your cousin's idea.
Bedtime.
Aww.
Oh.
Not you two.
Yay!
Yay!
Okie dokie, beddy bye, all tucked in, sweet dreams.
Just so you know, you're never gonna be my dad.
I think I can live with that.
Are these beds made out of bombs?
Yes, but they are very old and highly unlikely to blow up. But try not to toss and turn.
Cool.
Well, you have it as a bedtime story.
No.
I'm staying on the sleep without a bedtime story.
Well then, it's going to be a long night for you, isn't it? So good night, sleep tight, don't let the bedbugs bite, because there are literally thousands of them. Oh, and there's probably something in the closet.
He's just kidding, Agnes. And then the minions give her a fucking toilet brush. That looks like a rattle.
It's beautiful.
Okay. The next day, Gru thanks the girls outside, but they are wearing ballet outfits.
Girls, let's go. Time to deliver the cookies.
Okay. But first, we're going to go to dance class.
Actually, we're going to have to skip the dance class today.
Actually, we can skip the dance class today. We have a big recital coming up. We're doing an excerpt from Swan Lake. Yeah, Swan Lake.
That's fantastic, wonderful. But we're going to have to deliver cookies. Come on.
No.
No.
I'm not going to deliver cookies until we can do dance class.
Well, I am not driving you to the dance class. So if you want to go, you are going to have to walk yourselves.
Girls start walking.
But what are you doing?
Walking to dance class.
Yeah, okay, fine. You just keep walking because I'm really not driving you.
Okay.
Seriously, you are going to suffer the wrath of Gru. Seriously, I'm going to count to three. And you had better be in this car. One. Two.
Three and four and five and lift and stretch. Then Agnes comes on screen and gives Gru a ticket.
Here you go.
What is this?
Your ticket to the dance recital. You are coming, right?
Of course, I have pins and needles that I'm sitting on.
Pinky promise?
Oh yes, my pinky promises.
Agnes then fucks off, and we now cut to Vector's fortress.
Alright, our first customer is a man named Vector.
But he's a V. You know, we're supposed to start with the A's, and then go to the B's, then we go to the C's.
Yes, yes, I went to kindergarten. I know how the alphabet works. I was just thinking that it might be nice to deliver Mr. Vector's first, that's all.
The girls then go to...
It's almost over. It's almost over.
Ah, girls. Welcome back to my fortress, Vector dude. Oh, it's so funny. I have bronchitis. You got my cookies.
Really? Bronchitis Vector.
Chainsmoker Vector.
If we do the second movie, we need to make Lucy sound like a chain smoker.
Yeah, he gets a little girl.
Just the most raspy ass voice. Bring in their wagon. A Microsoft CookieBot program begins to run on Drew's computer. Margot consults her order from the two girls and Vector's boss is approved. And Vector's boss is a cookie put on the counter. Including the box with the robot cookies in them. Four boxes of mini mints, two toffee totes, and three thermal comfits, and 15 boxes of coconutties.
Exactly. I like to see somebody else order that many cookies. I likely name one person who's ordered more cookies than me.
That will be $52.
Right.
The cookie robots then sneak off set, and then some stuff happens. Vector pulls some money from his fanny pack that a fucking loser would wear.
7, 8, 9. Oh, tic tacs. 8, 9.
Are you wearing your pajamas?
They're pajamas. This is a warm-up suit.
The cookies are now at the vault that contains the shrink ray. And then it cuts back to Vector's kitchen.
What are you warming up for?
Stuff.
What sort of stuff?
Super cool stuff. You wouldn't understand.
Are you sleeping?
They're not pajamas. Here you go. 52 big ones.
Guru and two minions now finally enter the vault as the cookies have cut a hole in the wall. As they struggle to Vector eats a piece of metal like a dumbass, and Guru and the minions are shut in, so they sneak through the air ducts. One of the minions snaps the other's spine and shakes it like a fucking glow stick.
What was that? Might be nothing. Bye.
Just a rant. Then, while they're venting in Among Us, Guru falls through a weak spot. Guru falls through a weak spot in the floor. Your dangles precariously above Vector, who is mindlessly watching TV. Below Guru is Vector's pet shark, which swings freely through his fortress. The shark notices the dorsal that is Guru hanging by a thread. He is straining. The shark lunges, striking the glass floor.
What the? Quiet down, fish.
The shark continues to hit the glass floor.
Down, boy.
A third lunge knocks Gru and his minions from the ceiling, but it also knocks Vector off his couch, lodging his head into his bucket of snacks. Gru takes the opportunity to run the fuck away. And then, soon, Gru is waving his pants in the air. Around his arm. there's something.
Gru, you're too busy playing Among Us.
I think this is him all stutter.
Okay, page 58.
Wait, am I supposed to talk or something?
Yeah, bottom of page 50.
49.
We did it. Come on, girls, let's go.
Gru and the girls strive home. Gru is feeling very good. But what about the other people who ordered cookies?
Hold on, I gotta eat these. Life is full of disappointments for some people.
Hold on.
We only got the millisecond at the beginning and the millisecond at the end. Don't do that.
Super Saiyan Man, can we go, please?
No.
But we've never been, and it's the funnest place on Earth.
Don't care.
Please. We'll never ask for anything ever again.
That's the most confusing accent what? I've ever heard.
Don't make everything southern.
Fine.
I don't we'll even know what it was.
Sorry, dude. They can't ride without the adult, man.
What?
Honestly, that's like... And then a roller coaster. They... probably died. I don't know. That works. And suddenly, Agnes sees something off screen and point.
Look up! Look at the fluffy unicorn! It's so fluffy, I'm gonna die!
You haven't let us play for it.
No.
Fine.
Now much for the fluffy unicorn. Jesse.
Well, it's not fail, but all you gotta do is to win it is knock down that little spaceship there. It's easy.
Gunfire.
Pop, 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 pop.
Wait. Come on, one more time.
One more? I accidentally closed my eyes.
Skibbity bop bop boop.
I hit it.
Aww.
Whoa. What was that? She hit that. I saw that with my own eyes.
Hey, buddy. Let me explain something to you. You see that little tin spaceship? You see how it's not knocked over? Do you know what that means, Professor? It means you don't get the unicorn.
Uh-oh.
Someone's got a frown face. Better luck next time.
Okay. My turn. Knocked over.
Agnes gets her unicorn and the vendor probably dies.
It's so fluffy!
That was awesome.
You blew up the whole thing.
Let's go destroy another game.
Later that day, the people arrive home after having a actually fun day. Amazing.
Gru, do you mind if I had a quick word?
Okay, girls, go play. I got the shinkry. Cotton candy.
We have 12 days until the moon is in optimum position. We can't afford any distractions.
Get me Perkins.
Two minions carry a presentation stand. The TV turns on.
Sorry to bother you, Mr. Perkins, but I figured out you would want to see this.
What? Well done, Gru. Rather impressive.
Now the rest of the plan is simple. I fly to the moon. I shrink the moon. I grab the moon. I sit on the toilet. What? Sorry. Would you excuse me for just 1 second? I told you not to touch my things. I told you 1,000 times.
You want a pizza?
Pizza? You just had lunch.
Not now, for dinner.
Dinner? Just fine, whatever. Just get back in there.
Can we get stuffed crust?
Ooh, stuffed crust.
I'll stuff you one.
You're funny.
Just don't come out of that room again. Alright, sorry about that. Where were we?
You were sitting on the toilet.
But no, I'm sorry. That was a little attempt at humor. I know how much you like to laugh inside. Now, I was saying...
You don't seem terribly focused, Gru.
Believe me, I am completely focused.
Hello? Whoa, that guy is huge!
I'm here, sweetie!
What are those? Children?
What are you girls doing? I told you to stay out of here!
Gru, stop!
No.
Freeze Ray. Mr. Gru.
As I was saying...
No need to continue. I've seen quite enough.
But my plan...
It is a great plan. I love everything about your plan. Except for one thing. You.
Look, Mom. I threw a picture of me landing on the moon.
Hold on, I gotta get the perfect voice of this.
Cool. Look, Mom, I made a prototype of the rocket out of macaroni.
Yeah.
Look, Mom, I made the real rocket based on the macaroni prototype.
Meh.
I don't understand.
Let's face reality, Gru. You've been at this for far too long, with far too little success. We're going to put our faith, our money, into a, well, younger villain.
But I...
It's over, Gru. Or, it's over. Goodbye, Gru.
Now I know there have been some rumors going around that the bank is no longer funding us. Well, I am here to put those rumors to rest. They are true. We have no money. So how will we get to the moon? The answer is clear. We won't. We are doomed. Now would probably be a good time to look for other employment options. I know I have fired up my resume, as I suggest that all of you do as well. What is it? Can't you see that I'm in the middle of a pop top?
Who's that giving a piggy bank?
Yes, we will build a rocket using this and whatever else we can find. Grab everything, hit the junkyards, take apart the cars. Who needs the bank? Skip over all that.
Yeah, montage time.
A montage.
We got a montage.
What are you doing here?
And there she is in... Jeez, what was that? Jeez, why am I doing a Jersey accent?
New Jersey.
And there he's in the bathtub. I can't... voice. And they no. I'm choking. Hold on, I gotta think about this.
He's throwing.
Oh, no,
he's throwing.
Looks like a girl. Yes, an ugly girl.
And he's in the bathroom.
Not cool.
Oh, not. And she is all dressed up in his Sunday best.
He looks like a girl.
Yes, he does. An ugly girl.
Wait.
Go to page 65.
Okay. Mr. Perkins, your son is here.
Send him in.
Hey, Dad. Bronchitis hanging on me. You want to see me?
Yes, I did, Victor.
I am not Victor anymore. Victor was my nerd name. Now I am Victor.
Sit down. Do you know where the shrink ray is?
Back at my place.
Oh, is that right? Is that right? Back at your place. Oh, that's cool. I guess Gru must have one that looks exactly like it.
Hey, those girls sold me cookies.
Do you have any idea how lucrative this moon heist could be? I give you the opportunity of a lifetime and you just blow it.
No, I didn't.
Oh, really?
You just wait until Gru sees my latest weapon. Squid launcher. Oh, yeah.
Oh,
Don't worry.
There's a squid on my gun.
The moon is as good as ours, all right?
Oh, it's my turn. Okay. Come on, it's bedtime. Did you brush your teeth? Let me smell. You did not. Put on your PJs. Hold still. Okay, seriously. This is petty by time right now. I am not kidding around. I mean it.
But we're not tired.
Well, I am tired.
A bedtime story?
No.
Pretty please?
The physical appearance of that, please, makes no difference. It is still no. So go to sleep.
But we can't. We're all hyper.
But I'm about a bedtime story. We'll just be getting up and bugging you all night long.
Ah, fine. All right. Sleepy kittens. What are these?
You use them to tell the story.
Okay, let's get this over with. Three kittens love to play. They had fun in the sun all day. Their mother came out and said,
time for kittens to go to bed. I was thinking about some rhymes. Oh, wow. This is garbage. You actually like this?
Keep reading!
Come on.
Right. Okay, all right. Three little kittens starting the ball. Mommy, we're not tired at all. The mother smiled and said with a purr, fine, but at least you should brush your fur.
Now you brush the fur.
What, this is literature? A two-year-old could have written this. All right. Three little kittens with fur all brushed said, we can't sleep. We feel too rushed. Their mother replied with a voice like silk. Fine, but at least you should drink my milk. I think you're...
Whoa. I don't like this book. This is going on forever.
I don't like it either. The three little kittens with milk all gone,
rubbed their eyes and started to yawn. That's what I meant to say, yawn. Can't even cry. So their mother sang a lullaby. Good night, kittens. Close your eyes. Sleep in peace. Oh, while you sleep, we are apart. Your mommy loves you with all her fire. The end. Okay, good night.
Hey.
What?
What about good night kisses?
No. There will be no kissing, no hugging, or kissing.
It's not
going to
kiss
us
goodnight. I like him. He's nice.
But scary.
Like Santa.
The girl walks down the hallway, noticing his family tree. But then...
Drink my milk.
Only 48 hours...
Please just randomly say
only 48 hours to the launch, and all systems are go.
About that, I was thinking that maybe we could move the date of the heist.
Please tell me that this is not as a result of the girls' dance recital, is it?
No, the recital? No, that's stupid. I just think it's kind of weird to do it on a Saturday. I was thinking maybe the heist could be on a Tuesday thing, right? I want to see them drink their milk.
Gru, you and I have been working on this for years. It's everything we've dreamed of. Your chance to make history. Become the man who stole the moon. But these girls are becoming a major distraction. They need to go. If you don't do something about it, I will.
I understand. Nothing.
Good.
No. All right, now when we put our cups together, we will make the clink sound with our mouths. Ready? Eat it. Clink. There we go. Now we drink. And Agnes, clink. Very good, very good. Excuse me, girls. Don't worry, I'll be back. Keep clinking. Oh, where is Addie? What are you doing here?
I'm here for the girls. I received a call that you wanted to return. Also, I put in purchase a the Spanish dictionary. I didn't like what you said.
But I... Oh, I will get the girls ready.
Kangaroo, tell her that you want to keep us.
All right, girls, come on, let's go. Goodbye, Mr. Groom. Thank you for everything.
I did it for your own good. Come on, let's go get that moon.
All right. Right. What is this for?
Recital.
The recital. I am the greatest criminal mind of the century. I don't need to go to little girls' dance recitals.
Opening bay doors. Commencing launch sequence, and we are good to go in T-minus 10 seconds. 10, 9, 8, 7, 6, 5, 4, oh, it's not so canon.
Oh yeah!
Oh yeah!
Nice work, Doctor. All systems go.
My flight suit. Oh yeah, once again, the mind of Victor.
The tiny little sound of your hands hitting together.
I should be. I'm the sound effects director. If you did not notice. Oh, this is literally just stealing the moon. I'm still stealing the moon. I'm hitting the I've got it. I've got the moon. I've got the moon. I can make it.
Wait a minute. How?
Oh, get in.
Give me.
Come on, come on.
Where? Why would he come? Give us up.
But the pink promised.
Girls, girls, princess.
No, we can't start yet. We're still expecting someone.
You just wait a few more minutes?
All right, but just a few more minutes. He's not coming, guys.
Gru, can you hear me? quick, we've got to warn him, and fast.
Yeah.
Okay, there's the library. That's 3rd Street. That's the dance studio. There it is. Jesse, you're the janitor.
I have to think of a voice now.
Sorry, buddy. Show's over.
I love how the voice you have for Vector and literally every other character would go well with the janitor. What the janitor actually did in the movie. And you chose something the opposite. Over?
Yeah.
Vector, open up.
First, give me the moon, then we'll talk.
Mr. Who?
Zip it. Happy meal.
Oh, now the girls.
Actually, I think I'll hold on to them for a little while longer.
No.
Oh, yeah. Unpredictable.
No. Listen here. Listen close, you little punk. You have no idea what you're dealing with. When I get in there, you are in for a world of pain.
Oh. I am really scared.
He's gonna kick your ass.
He punched my shark.
There he is. Hang on, Gru. Oh no. Speeding along pretty quick here.
Vector has the girls. Go. That's me, isn't it? What happened to the ship? It's big again.
Not as big as the moon's going to be.
What?
The larger the mass of an object, the quicker the effects of the shrink ray wear off. I call it the Nefario principle. I just came up with it now, actually.
That's genius. Oh no.
It crushes
the cotton leg. Did you see that? Vector, I can't help!
What are you girls doing back there?
I always forget his voice. Get as close as you can. You got it. You both have to say I.
Woo!
Mr. Gru up here.
Mr. Gru.
Okay, girls, you're going to have to jump.
Jump? Are you insane?
Don't worry, I'll get you.
You gave us back!
I know, and it is the worst mistake I've ever made. But you have to jump now. Ba 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 ba.
You'll be okay.
Okay, girls.
Jump now!
Both have to scream. Margo, I will catch you, and I will never let you go again.
Not so fast.
Margo.
Let me go!
No!
Moon, it fucking kills Vector again, and Margo flies out the door. Margo screams as she falls.
I'm coming, Margo. I'm coming. Margo, hang on.
I got to.
No.
No, it had no has to be longer and more dramatic.
No.
Bronchitis. My bronchitis. Oh, poop.
Okay, girls, I'm for bit.
You missed the newscaster.
Oh, right. This time, good triumphs and moon has been returned to its rightful place in the sky. But once again, law enforcement is baffled, leaving everyone to wonder, who is this mysterious hero? And what will he do next? Okay, girls, time for bed for a second time.
Ah, come on. We want a story.
No, not a story. That book was accidentally destroyed maliciously tonight. So we're going to read a new book. This one is called One Ginorma Unicorn. By who wrote this? Oh, me. I wrote it. Oh, look. It's a puppet book. That's a horn.
This is going to be the best book ever.
Not to pat myself on the back, but yes, it probably will be. Here we go. One big unicorn, strong and free, thought he was happy as could be. Then three little kittens came around and turned his whole life upside down.
Hey, that one looks like me.
What are you talking about? These are kittens. Any relation to persons living or dead is completely coincidental. They made them laugh. Aha! They made them cry. Ooh. He should have said goodbye. And now he knows he could never be apart from those three little kittens that are gonna bang Jana Fang. That is his heart. Beat. The end. Okay, all right, good night.
And he ventures to kiss Marco. He gives him a big hug.
I hate you.
Bruce smiles.
You're sleeping on the bomb, so.
You're the one sleeping on the bomb.
On the earth, I fart you too. No, the minions all sighed disappointed. That wasn't the part of the voice, but that was Oh, all right. Didn't I get you already?
Classical music! The dance recital! Privately for
Blue. They're very good.
Hey, Blue's mom is also there for some reason.
Jesse?
Oh, I am so proud of you, son. You found out to be a great parent. Just like me. Maybe even better. Don't ask KGB about that.
No, I'm fine. Go ahead. No. Hey. Dancing. Yeah, finally. Stop recording this.
Vector is probably dead.
Vector Nefario dances.
Yeah.
And credit rolls.
Credit rolls, yeah, for, yeah, fucking people.
Yes. For people.
All right, what about this Despicable Me too, guys?
No, we're not. Yeah, no, but probably not tonight. Unless you guys are really feeling up for it, because it's really fun.
No, we can't read two scripts in one night.
Here we go. Focus. Speed. I am speed. One winner. 42 losers. I eat losers for breakfast. Breakfast. Maybe I should have had breakfast. A little brekkie could be good for me. No. Stay focused. Speed. I'm faster than fast, quicker than quick. I am lightning.